It is the beauty of football. A little rain isn't going to stop the teams from playing. In fact, it makes the games even more fun. It was opening night for Kansas high school football teams, and in Olathe, that meant a marquee matchup between East and South. They met in the state semifinals a year ago, so tonight was a huge rematch. Of Hy-Vee as the game of the week. To make that presentation from Hy-Vee is Lisa Michael.
Thank you very much. It is my pleasure to welcome the first game of the year, Olathe South and Olathe East. We're happy to be part of high school sports, and congratulations for game of the week.
To say the conditions were not good is an understatement, folks. The rain and wind caused the scene to look like the fog was in. A lot of slipping and sliding going on, but it did not stop South running back Chase Hansen. He finds the open hole. Now he's off and running to the races, as they say. 76 yards later, he's going into the end zone for the touchdown. It is 6-0, Olathe South on top. Let's go. East has the ball, fourth and goal on the 1 yard line. Number 24, Thomas McHugh, trips up East running back. And then number 44, Sterling Lehman, finishes the job. No points for the East on that occasion. As a matter of fact, no points for East at all. The final score, South 6, East nothing.
Okay, it is raining tonight, but here at Grandview, that's not really a problem because they have brand new turf, and they were proud to have their first game tonight against William Christman, and so far, it's brought them good luck.
The Bulldogs were up by 14 points, then watched the Bears claw their way back in it. From the 7, Dylan Cole rolls out, finds Alex Ball by the end zone, Ball leaps up to make the catch and falls over the goal line. It's 14-6. But the Bears botch the point after attempt. Second quarter, out of the shotgun, Cole fakes the handoff, runs up the gut on a 13-yard touchdown play. The Bears try for two and get it. This game is even at 14. But the Dogs weren't about to let anyone rain on their parade. After a pass interference call from the 8, Javon Turner up the middle for the touchdown. Add two, it was 22-14. Grandview went on to win this game 42-14. Over at O'Hara, the Celtics led by 3 touchdowns over Lincoln Prep at the half, but they wanted more. In a steady downpour, Michael Briggs goes to the air. He connects with Peter Briggs. That sets up O'Hara at the 14. A couple of plays later, Briggs scores on a quarterback keeper. O'Hara was up by 28-0. As for the final score, the Celtics won 35-0.
Karen, thank you very much. Bonus Football Patrol, Blue Valley taking on Gardner-Edgerton, opening kickoff of the season. Blue Valley kicks off to Anthony Smart. Well, the sophomore bobbles the ball, but it ain't over yet, folks. He picks it up at the 5, weaves his way back the middle, and there he goes. Speed will kill you. It's see you later. He goes 95 yards for the touchdown, 2-point conversion, and it's 8-0 Gardner-Edgerton. Go to the second quarter, Blue Valley going for it on 4th-and-3, deep in Gardner territory. Quarterback Henry McGrew keeps the ball himself. Not only does he get the first down, but the touchdown as well. The 2-point conversion failed, and it's 8-6. That's the way it ended, with Gardner Edgerton hanging on for an 8-6 victory over Blue Valley. Now, let's check out some scores from around our football patrol.